Happy Friday nights and welcome back.
On today's show, we'll visit an amazing teacher right here on campus, check out a couple of Higley hotspots you won't want to miss, and get the inside scoop from Stucco about some exciting plans for the year ahead.
All this and so much more on today's episode of The Studio. Good morning, Knights. I'm Aislinn Sweeney.
And I'm Kylie Brinkman.
With the fall season just starting up, there are plenty of exciting sporting events to attend on campus. Maddie and Kenzie spoke with some of the talented girls playing flag football to find out more about the sport and the team.
This year's Higley's girls flag football season has kicked off. We caught up with several players and Coach Shar to get their insights and expectations for the season.
Last year was our first year doing flag football at Higley, and it was really nerve-wracking first trying out for the team because I didn't know how it would be and how the coaches coach, but I've really enjoyed it so far, and it's given me a lot of really good memories and a lot of good friendships.
I'm so excited about our team this year. I think our attitudes are the best they've ever been. I think the girls are so like ready to work and get after it, and they're so eager for the season to start and to win.
Flag football offers a supportive and welcoming environment for any Higley girl looking to get involved.
I love how supportive flag football is because even when you drop a ball or you mess up, your friends still pick you up and tell you that you still did good and no one remembers that you dropped the ball.
I think when I first joined the program, I felt like not nervous, but just a little like unsure. But now I think over the years, I've just gotten better with practice, and like I think every game you get better and learn the sport more.
Coach Shar is a very determined coach, and she encourages failure because it then becomes success.
My favorite part of being a coach is actually mentoring these young ladies, building a relationship with them, seeing their growth, letting them enjoy the game, enjoying the game with them.
Last season, I think we did really well. We went to the semifinals and we lost, and that was really hard. But as a team, I think that loss last year brought us together, and now we're ready to go and go further and win.
I would recommend this sport because it's super easy to learn. The coaches are super helpful if you're new, and it's perfect for people of any ability, and it's super fun.
I would just say anyone that is interested in it, hey, come give it a try. You know, you either like it or you don't like it.
Whether you're passionate about the sport or just looking for a fun time on the field, consider joining Higley's girls flag football team.
This has been Maddie and Kenzie reporting for The Studio. Knights, the Armory is now open during both lunches. Stop by and grab some refreshing Arizona tea and some delicious snacks.
A new hotspot for your morning coffee just opened up near Higley. Scooters offers a wide selection of drinks and baked goods, and with many nights working there, Roma and Kylie stopped by to check it out.
Kylie and I stopped by to check out a new coffee shop just down the road, Scooters. We talked to some Higley Knights who work there to find out more about it.
Hi, my name is Kayla Chow and I work at Scooters Coffee. I just graduated from Higley in May.
I think that what sets Scooters apart from like other coffee shops like Dutch Bros and Black Rock or anything like that are really the prices for what you get. Just working here is also super nice just because I like to put a lot of my personality in how I talk into the customers. So I think it kind of adds to their experience.
Hi, I'm McKenna and I'm a senior at Higley.
I applied at Scooters because every single time I went to a coffee place, everyone in there just seemed like they were having so much fun and I get amazing drinks out of it, so.
I would say the most rewarding part of this job is definitely getting to work with my best friends. Like the vibe is just so much fun and every shift just feels like a party.
I would describe the atmosphere here as super laid back. It's really casual and it's more fun than it is like any other regular job. It's all girls here, which I think really adds to that environment.
We wanted to get a behind the scenes look at how their drinks are made.
So today I'm making a pumpkin spice chai. So basically all that you need for that is just depending on the size, we're gonna add pumps of our chai syrup that we have. And then we also just got some of the pumpkin spice sauce or syrup that you can add in there as well.
If you're still not sure what to order, McKenna and Kayla have some recommendations that you should be sure to try.
We have a ton of different like varieties of different candy bar drinks. We also just opened up our fall selection today.
My favorite drink here is definitely a matcha with raspberry syrup. It's really good. If you haven't tried it, I would give it a try.
If you'd like to keep up with us, you can follow us on Instagram at ScootersCoffeeAZ, or you can come and scoot on around.
Be sure to try out Scooter's Coffee on Pecos and Power and say hi to your fellow Knights while you're at it. This is Roma and Kylie signing off for The Studio.
A Night of the Arts was hosted in the HCPA by the Higley Marching Band. It was an incredible show with unforgettable performances from our talented Higley Knights.
Then there was the cat!
The cat!
The cat!
Is this about the fact that I think you look great? I hate skinny girls.
Every year, Higley welcomes new staff members to the kingdom. Trent recently caught up with a new addition to the math department to find out what it's like being a new teacher on campus.
X equals negative one. What does the line x equals negative one look like?
With the beginning of another school year, there are plenty of new faces on campus. Among these is a new member of the math department. We got to know Ms. McCoy and heard a little bit more about the new algebra teacher.
I'm Ms. McCoy, and I teach math at Higley College Algebra and Algebra 2. I was born in Oklahoma, but was pretty much raised in Gilbert, Arizona. I went to Gilbert High School, and then after I graduated, I went to NAU for both my bachelor's and my master's, both degrees in mathematics, and it was a great experience. Both of my parents were math teachers growing up, and so they were definitely a big influence on my decision to do math and to specifically go into teaching.
Getting her start as a college instructor, Ms. McCoy is new to the experience of teaching high school.
I think I am most looking forward to getting to know everyone working here and going to school here. In college, you're only meeting with students 2 to 3 times a week. In high school, you're seeing them every single day, so you can definitely form closer relationships with the students. Definitely a challenge of teaching math is just, I think for many students, they have a general fear of math right from the start. And I think students can be generally surprised at how much they can do without any help at all. Math is cumulative. It just adds up and builds. And so everything that you are learning in those early math classes are going to be used later on. Learn it now, and that way you don't have to relearn it later on.
All in all, Ms. McCoy's passion for the subject is evident in all of her lessons, and Higley is excited to welcome the new teacher to campus. This is Trent, signing off for The Studio.
At the start of the year, many teachers use icebreakers to help students get comfortable with each other. Recently, the theater department hosted a game night, giving students a fun and memorable way to connect with their new classmates.
Stucco has been hard at work making sure the school year gets off to a great start. Sophia and Trevor caught up with our student body president and vice president to learn more about who they are and how they plan to make high school the best it can be.
As the new school year begins, Stucco is busy planning exciting events. Sophia and I caught up with Stucco leaders to learn more about what they have in store.
Hey guys, I'm Diego. I'm the student body president here at Higley. Stucco's goal for the student body is just to make sure that everyone has a good time. My own personal role is just the basic communication from admin and our student body. So from listening to what our student body wants and then bringing it back to admin, and then Stucco helps make it possible. So example, like homecoming. We make homecoming possible for you guys. We plan it. We have everything that you guys need so that you guys can come top out and have fun.
From dances to assemblies, Stucco is dedicated to making your freshman year memorable. They also have some great tips on how to make the most out of your high school experience.
Hi, I'm Allison Ewing, and I am your student body vice president. The advice I would give to a freshman is to get involved. Honestly, that was what made me happy here at Higley, because if you live the same day of 7:25 to 2:15 every single day, it gets boring and it doesn't make you excited to go to school.
Honestly, make the most of it. It's 4 years of your life that you're never gonna get back.
So getting involved from clubs to sports.
Go to games, go to dances.
Make your time here worth it.
Getting involved is a fantastic way to enjoy high school, so be sure to stay informed about upcoming events.
So upcoming events that you guys should look out for, we have our fall like sport pep assembly coming in on September 30th. And then in October, we have our homecoming assembly, which is on the 18th. And then we have homecoming on the 19th, Saturday, so be there.
Get hype, we have so much fun things. So be sure to stay tuned and check out our Instagram, the studio, or the weekly newsletter, or flyers and posters around campus.
Keep an eye out for these dates and fun activities coming your way. Take care, and this has been Trevor and Sophia signing off for The Studio.
Football season is underway, and with two wins already on the board, we're excited to see how today's game unfolds. Don't miss out, there are only four home games this season, so come out to cheer on your Higley Knights.
Every year we welcome foreign exchange students to Higley. Aislinn and Lana sat down with one of them to get an inside look about what it's like to spend a year abroad so far from home.
To many, traveling thousands of miles across the world would be daunting, but for Victoria, it's an exciting opportunity to try something new.
Hi, my name is Victoria. I'm from Poland and I'm a senior. I chose Arizona because of the weather. I was watching a lot of movies that just popped up. It's hot and sunny and it's just easier to get up.
There are many aspects of our society that may seem normal to you, but would surprise those from abroad.
People around here are more outgoing. You know, they're smiling everywhere and they're asking, how are you? In Poland, people are not like that. The weather never gets as hot as here. It's more green and people are walking. People here just use cars to go anywhere and we can just walk.
Having foreign exchange students in class can provide teachers different perspectives.
Hi, I'm Miss Hafen. I teach Spanish here at Higley High School. Victoria is a very good student. She seems very reserved. She's in a class with underclassmen, and she is a bit older than them, and her maturity level definitely shows.
School can be difficult at times, and having to learn in a different language can prove challenging.
I've began to understand that they're not only going from English to Spanish, they're going from their first language to English and then to Spanish. And so there's an extra step there that I think can present some different challenges that I am not aware of.
I had to learn many things in English in a different language. And it's not easy, but you can get used to it.
This is a process for her as far as taking a year off of her home country schooling to come and do this. And I hope to talk to her more to have her explain how it differs compared to what she experiences at home.
We can all learn a lot from people who have different experiences than us, and it's worth exploring. We wish Victoria a great rest of her year here at Higley. This is Aislinn and Lana signing out.
Next week is Surprise Spirit Week. Here's what's happening each day. Monday is Monday Nights, wear our school colors. Tuesday is Tourist Tuesday. Grab your maps and cameras and dress like you're ready for vacation. Wednesday is Wacky Wednesday. We want to see your crazy hair or hat, so go all out. Thursday is Dad Day, dress like a dad. And to wrap it all up, Friday is Nightlight. Light up the halls by dressing in neon. Be sure to participate and show your school spirit all week long.
Higley students are always on the lookout for their next after-school treat. Marshall and Miles met with a local business owner, Albert Suh, who might just have the perfect spot for them.
Today we looked into a local dessert shop, Frost Tales. We talked with the owner, Albert Suh, and asked him about his background, his business, and why Knights might be interested in getting a sweet treat.
So I went to ASU, started in 2003, came all the way from New Jersey, and ended up at the WP Carey Business School. I always had a heart for business just because my parents had their own business as well. And I felt bingsu was something that was new to introduce to Americans that felt like. And so that was kind of the key point, whereas just another Korean restaurant would be just another Korean restaurant. Bingsu, which is a Korean word, essentially means Korean shaved ice. We all know after ice cream, we feel like crap because it's heavy cream. But I'm creating a different alternative of ice cream that'll satisfy the same taste buds. If you get a small, typically it's about 90 calories or less. Not only is everything made fresh on the spot, it's healthy and it actually tastes amazing and it's refreshing. So in the beginning, we just had bingsu and then we added drinks and snacks. So as we got busier, I would reinvest the money back to the business. We actually got ranked one of the top places to drink in the Valley, according to Yelp last year. Our coffees are amazing. We have frappuccinos, matcha drinks, sodas, as well as non-carbonated drinks, Korean snacks from turtle chips to choco pies, banana milk, pulled duck noodles, the carbonara, a little bit of everything from Korea. And I actually drive out to LA about once every 6 weeks to pick everything up from the port. And then I bring it back. Our environment is in our name. It says Korean Dessert House. I want it to be your second home. right? Come and hang out with your friends, your significant other, family, somewhere you can just relax, have a treat, have a snack. It's just a very homely environment. The motivation is on my regular customers, customers that heard from other customers to come here. That to me right there says a lot, and that puts a smile on my face.
This is Miles and Marshall signing out for the studio.
The Girls Up Club is an empowering space where our female knights can come together and learn how to lead and inspire others in order to make a difference in our community. Meetings are in room 521 every other Monday.
Mr. Stevens is a beloved government teacher here on campus. Aiden stopped by the Social Studies building to find out what brought him to Higley.
Mr. Stevens is an outstanding government teacher on our campus. Originally from Nebraska, he moved to Arizona in search of better weather.
The things that brought me to Arizona were the weather, and the things that brought me to Higley were just knowing the reputation of the district.
He is dedicated to his students, and the success of his former students has greatly influenced the teacher he is today.
I think that my students in the past have helped shape my curriculum even for the future. When I do my history courses, I have my students who have lived through the last few years of history help me write what they would like future students to be able to learn from the time that they were in high school. And the students that are in the past have now kind of left a legacy.
Current students have nothing but praise for him, often speaking highly of his teaching style and dedication.
He's probably one of my favorite teachers. I just really liked how different it was every day from all the other classes that I've had up until high school, actually. It was a lot of fun, and we still did our work. Like, we still learned a lot.
In addition, Mr. Stevens offers a variety of unique and engaging activities in his classroom.
I do things on Tuesday. We do Tuesday Newsday. We talk about what's going on. It keeps us informed and understanding of what's happening out there in the world. So I also do a little bit of trivia. That's something in my personal life I started doing, and so I share some of that with the students as well.
If you sign up for a U.S. history or government, you may have the opportunity to have him as your teacher.
This is Aiden Dupree reporting for The Studio.
Last Thursday, Ms. Pierce's multicultural literature students paid a visit to the Heard Museum and the Frybread House for the unit on Native American literature. This experience furthered their appreciation for the cultures of indigenous people.
We hope you had a great week, Knights.
Be sure to join us next Friday for an all-new episode of The Studio.
Go Knights!